I'll show you how to fix and reduce background noise in Adobe Audition. After watching this video, you can get your noisy audio from this,
that low frequency hum,
to this,
produced by electronical gear like.
Import your audio file in a multi-track session, since that will enable a few functions you will need. That noise you hear when you record it too softly and you want to boost your audio. There are a few ways you can reduce or remove the background noise with Adobe Audition. The first one is by changing the volume of the noise in parts where you don't speak. This one works well when you have slight hiss or just a bit of echo happening. Below the track, you can open more lanes, and the first lane you see is volume. Add a few automation points like this and drag down the volume curve.
Hiss. That noise you hear when you record it too softly and you want to boost your audio.
You can fine-tune the curve to make it sound natural.
Hiss. That noise you hear when you record it too softly and you want to boost your audio.
This also works when you have too much echo in your track. Let me show you.
Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Subscribe to this channel.
Another way of changing the volume is to split the track and reduce the volume of the noisy clips and apply crossfades. Split the clip with, for instance, Ctrl K or Command K and reduce the volume in the lower left corner. Drag the clip over the preceding part and a crossfade is created automatically. This also works at the end of the clip. Tweak until it sounds natural.
That noise you hear when you record it too softly and you want to boost your audio.
And again, this method also works with echoey audio.
Subscribe to this channel.
If you have way more echo and hiss happening, keep watching. I'll show in a minute how to fix that. So, changing the volume works best when you don't have too much background noise going on. With slight wind noise and low rumble, you can look into reducing the low frequencies by using EQ, since this will be all over the audio.
Or something like wind noise.
You can see it's peaking a lot in the low end.
Or something like wind noise.
Apply a low shelf or EQ and turn it down until you find a balance between removing the low end wind noise and keeping the voice as intact as possible.
Or something like wind noise. Or something like wind noise. Or something like wind noise. Or something like wind noise.
Low end hum.
That low frequency hum, usually introduced by electronical gear like lights or power sockets,
can be removed by applying a small band EQ, like with this parametric equalizer. The frequencies of the hum are usually different depending on where you live in the world. It's either 50 Hz or 60 Hz, but usually also the multitudes of the hum called harmonics. For 50 Hz, it's for instance 100, 150, and so on. And for 60 Hz, it's 120, 180, etc. Reduce by turning down a frequency band and make the bandwidth smaller and repeat this process until it sounds better. Also check the other frequencies.
That low frequency hum, usually introduced by electronical gear like lights or power sockets.
It can go from this.
That low frequency hum, usually introduced.
To this.
Introduced by electronical gear like lights.
If that gets too tricky, you can use a plugin in Audition called Dehum. This will do the work for you. Select the right power grid hum, it's 50 Hz for this clip. And start by setting the number of harmonics to 1 and increase until the hum is gone.
Or power sockets. That low frequency hum, usually introduced by electronical gear like lights or power sockets.
You can see it applies small EQ dips, just as I demonstrated before. Tweak the harmonic slope and gain until you have a good balance between removing hum and keeping the voice intact. usually introduced by electronical gear like lights or power sockets. That low-frequency hum, usually introduced by electronical gear like lights or power sockets. Now this clip still has a lot of hiss happening, so let's apply denoising. That low-frequency hum, usually introduced by electronical gear like lights or power sockets. Denoise will learn the noise on the track and will reduce it. You can set here if you want the denoise to be focused more on certain areas. The amount of reduction can be set here. Experiment with what sounds best. Frequency hum, usually introduced by electronical gear like lights or power sockets. And when the echo can't be fixed with volume editing,
please remember to subscribe to this channel.
Use the plugin called D-Reverb. This will basically do the same as the denoise, but is tailored to remove echo, or reverb as it's actually called.
Please remember to subscribe to this channel.
It uses the same controls as the denoise, so pinpoint where most of the echo is happening and change the amount. Experiment again until it sounds good.
Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Please remember to subscribe to this channel.
If you are on the lookout for more advanced tools, you can always check programs like iZotope RX8, Steinberg's Spectralayers 7, or the Waves Restoration Bundle. You'll find the links to these plugins in the description below. If you want to learn more on how to remove background noise, check out my video displayed on screen right now. Please subscribe to the channel and share this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!